for those who don't know, I'm a vitreoretinal surgeon, and I've been treating eye diseases for 34 years, limiting my practice to surgery and pharmacotherapy of vitreous, macula, and retina. And the reason that we're here today is because vitreous is the gel that fills the center of the eye, and that's the origin of the visual phenomenon of floaters, which are shadows that are cast upon the retina by opacities in the vitreous body. And so the vitreous requires treatment in various diseases, but the phenomenon of floaters has previously not been considered a disease by the medical profession. And that is the source of your frustration. That is the difficulty that you experience when seeing doctors who don't really understand your condition and tend to push things away that they don't understand. And I was guilty of that myself for many years. And it results in a fairly insensitive and callous perspective on your problem. And it takes a lot of time and effort to change people's minds, especially something as conservative and traditional as medicine. But movements such as this can make headway and can make a significant impact on people's perceptions and their strength in numbers. So as your organization, as our organization grows, you'll see a greater impact. When Fabio and I started this project, the intent was first and foremost education and public awareness, bringing to people's consciousness the issue of floaters and how not all floaters are benign, that there are conditions where it's truly a disease. And that's the reason that we came up with the name vision degrading myodysopsia. It's not an easy term to say, but it's intentionally technical because it sounds like a disease. And that's the first step in the paradigm shift that has to occur before the doctors and nurses in the world accept this as a disease. So it has a name, and we're trying to focus all of our efforts on better understanding vision degrading myodysopsia. We call it VDM for short, and to develop new diagnostics that will enable new therapeutics. The research efforts that we're undertaking are very important because it furthers our mission, which was education and public awareness. The fundraising aspects have become very important, but I hasten to emphasize that when we started, we really wanted to meet an unmet need, which was an improved understanding of vitreous and vitreous floaters and the cases of vision degrading myodysopsia that are the suffering individuals throughout the world. And there are many, 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 much more than you would think. We actually don't know how many, and that's one of the objectives that the VDM project wants to approach, and that is get a better understanding of how prevalent this condition is. And I'll touch upon that a little bit later. But from education and public awareness, we've extended to fundraising, which has become an important aspect of what we do. And again, I congratulate you and particularly Fabio for attaining the goals in December and January and raising the bar for the future. That's quite commendable to not be satisfied with success, but to seek greater success. And the sufferers worldwide will be the beneficiaries of your efforts.